स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर टीचर रागनी तिवारी, एन इंग्लिश टीचर. स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन वी आर हियर विद द सेम बुक फ्लेमिंगो एंड द सेम स्टोरी लॉस्ट स्प्रिंग. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी एंड वी हैव स्टार्टेड इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी एंड कवर्ड सम पोर्शन ऑफ दिस स्टोरी. इन फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द character Sahib-e-Alam, and now in second part we are discussing the story of Mukesh. Narrator was telling us about the story of Mukesh, that how narrator conveys the message of lost spring through this character. Now let us know, as we have already covered these two paragraphs in which Mukesh had taken narrator to his home. Now what happened there, let's see. We all are here. We enter a half-built shack. Please underline the words shack. In one part of it, thatched with dead grass, is a firewood stove over which sits a large vessel of sizzling spinach leaves. On the ground, a large aluminium platters. Are more chopped vegetables. A frail young woman is cooking the evening meal for the whole family. Through eyes filled with smoke, she smiles. So students, in this paragraph, the story starts. The house where Mukesh lived was partially constructed hut. Okay? In one corner was a firewood stove. Made with dead grass. A vessel with spinach leaves was kept on it. And on the ground, there were more plates with chopped vegetables in them. What is the meaning of shack? Shack means A roughly built hut. Thatched means covered with dry grass. Sizzling here means a kind of a sound when frying or cooking. Okay? It is a kind of a sound when we are frying something on stove or cooking. So here the narrator describes the situation of the atmosphere of the house of Mukesh, where some chopped vegetables also kept on the ground in plates. There was a thin young woman cooking the evening meal. Frail means a thin, weak. Okay, she seems so sick, very weak, very thin. There was a thin young woman cooking the evening meal for the family. Her eyes were full of the smoke emanating from the stove. Smoke which is emanating from the stove. So her eyes were full of with that smoke. Even then, still she was so cheerful and smiled to see the writer. Why she smiled? She smiled when she saw the writer, because that time writer was in Mukesh's house. She is the wife of the lady, the thin lady. She is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother, not much older in years. She has begun to command respect as the Bahu, the daughter-in-law of the house, already in charge of three men. Although she was not much older than Mukesh, okay? She was not much older than Mukesh. She was a responsible person and was worthy to get respect from the family as the daughter-in-law. She took care of three men. Who were those three men? Her husband, Mukesh, and their father. Okay. When the older man enters, she gently withdraws behind the broken wall and brings her veil closer to her face. Withdraw. Veil. As custom demands, daughter-in-law must veil their faces before male elders. In this case, the elder is an improvised bangle maker. Despite long years of hard labor, first as a tailor, then a bangle maker, he has failed to renovate a house. Renovate a house, send his two sons to school. All he has managed to do is teach them what he knows, the art of making bangle. From here to here, underline improvised and withdraws. Withdraws means goes back. Withdraws means goes back. And improvised means very poor. Improvised means very poor. Okay. So here, as Mukesh's father entered the house, the daughter-in-law hid behind the wall. As Mukesh's father entered the house, the daughter-in-law hid behind the wall and covered her face behind her veil. Covered her face behind her veil. Veil is a part of that cloth which that lady worn. Okay, like sari's portion. A sari's portion. It was a tradition. In Hindi, veil is called ghungat. Now, I hope you all have understood. So, she covered her face behind her veil. It was a tradition for the daughter-in-laws to hide their face in the presence of the older male members of the family. The elder here was a poor bangle maker. He had worked hard all his life. The elder, the improvised elder, the poor elder, he worked hard all his life. How? First as a tailor. Earlier, the old bangle maker was a tailor. Earlier, he was a tailor. And now, he was a bangle maker. Now, he was a bangle maker. He was still not able to either renovate the house or send his sons to school. He had just managed, how much he managed? Only he managed to teach them, which he knows already, that making bangles. Making bangles only he taught them. Now, next. It is his karma, his destiny, says Mukesh's grandmother, who has watched her own husband go blind with the dust from polishing the glass of bangles. Can a God-given lineage ever be broken? She implies. She implies. Lineage implies added or explained or justified. She justified or she implies or she added. What she explained? That Mukesh's grandmother justified her son. She justified her son by saying that it was his destiny. He was destined to make bangles. It was his karma. It was his destiny. He was destined to make bangles as it had been their family profession. It had been their family profession. She had seen her husband. What she saw? She had seen her husband become blind due to the dust from the polishing the glass bangles. Due to the dust polishing the glass bangles. Her husband went blind. She said that their family had got this art of bangle making from God. Okay? They have got this profession from God. And so they had to carry on the tradition. Lineage is a tradition. Okay? Carry on the tradition. They had to carry on the tradition. It can't be broken. It cannot be broken. So born in the caste of bangle makers, they have seen nothing but bangles. In the house, in the yard, in every other house, every other yard, every street in Firozabad, spirals of bangles like sunny gold, paddy green, royal blue, pink, purple, every color born out of the seven colors of the rainbow lies in mounds, please underline it. In unkempt yards are piled on four-wheeled handcarts, pushed by young men along the narrow lanes of shanty town. Okay, from here, so they were born in a particular caste. What they observed, that they were born in a particular caste which had to follow the profession of bangle making. They had to follow the profession of bangle making. All their life they had just seen these bangles only. What they saw in all their life, only bangles, nothing else. All their life they had seen just bangles only, and they were everywhere, wherever you can see in Firozabad, in the streets of that bangle making portion, you can see only bangles. They were everywhere, like in the backyard. Yard here means in the backyard, the back portion of the house, backyard, and in the next houses, the neighborhood houses, in their yards, their own yards, and even in the streets of the town, even in the streets of the Firozabad, there were huge spiral bunches of bangles. What is the meaning of spirals? Spiral here means a plain curve traced by a point circling. Okay, it is a curve of bangles. When bunch of bangles were put somewhere, it is called spirals. What is the meaning of mounds? Mounds means heaps, dher. Okay, unkempt means not taken care of, carelessly. Piled, again heaps. Okay, shanty town means the town full of small and roughly built huts. That is shanty towns. So there were huge spiral bunches of bangles in different colors, various colors bangles. There were bangles of all rainbow colors. How many colors they can make from that rainbow? 7 colors, many colors of bangles. Further, the writer says that there were bangles in the neglected yards also. Bangles in the neglected yard also. Neglected, that careless, or yards unkempt. Neglected, okay, neglected yard also, and they were dumped on hand carts for sale. They were dumped on hand carts for sale. They were pushed by men. Those hand carts were pushed by men, young men, along the street of Firozabad. And in dark hutments next to lines of flames of flickering, please underline it, flickering oil lamps, sit boys and girls with their fathers and mothers, welding pieces of colored glass into circles of bangles. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside, and that is why they often end up losing their eyesight before they become adults. What here writers, the narrator conveys the message. The writer describes the environment where these bangle makers work. In this paragraph, the writer describes the environment where these bangle makers work. They were small. What kind of environments were there? They were small dark huts. The children would sit next to the line of oil lamps. Oil lamps were lighting up there, and which were flickering. Flickering means unsteady. Okay, unsteady, which is not stable, which lights are not stable. They, along with their parents, they sat along with their parents, joined the pieces of colored glass into circles. That is that circle called bangles. Welding means joining. Joined the pieces of colored glass into circles, that is called bangles. As they spent a lot of time in the dark, they spent lot many time in the dark only, in that dark portion only. So their eyes would not adapt to the bright sunlight. Okay, their eyes would not be habitual to the dark bright sunlight. So many of them lost their eyesight before gaining adulthood. Many of the children lost their eyesight before gaining adulthood. So students, this is for today. Please listen this video again and again, try and understand, and please take care of these hard words and start solving NCERT questions also. Okay, till then, take care, have a nice day.